You know, if you keep looking up at the top of the pyramid, you will see the light.
Oh, hi. We're going to the South Lyon car wash. This is quite cool. You wait till you see the Leo fountain out in front. Everything in here is either about horses or lions, because of the name of the town, named after Lyon in France. It's spelled L-Y-O-N. I'm Marilyn Morgan, by the way. Sorry about that. I didn't introduce myself, but we're not in our usual frame where I'm set up and we're going to interview somebody. I'm actually talking to you, talking about the town that I live in. In the future, we're planning on going around different businesses and out in this area. We've recently been out in West Bloomfield. Yeah? And this guy's going to ask me for money.
Unfortunately.
Smile, you're on candid camera. What's your name, sir?
Ed.
Ed?
Yes, ma'am.
Ed, we're with Schwack. We do a cable show. So
all
we
right.
do, I live in South Lyon and we go around to different businesses.
No
but
problem.
We're doing this. He thinks this is fun.
All right.
With your car wash here
right.
that you work at. And this is the South Lyon car wash, correct?
Yes, ma'am.
So we're going to get a great wash.
Yes, ma'am.
Now, how much might that be?
It'd be $5.
Okay.
Would you like a dash wipe or air freshener? Or a dash wipe, wipe down your dashboard while you're going through?
Yeah.
All right, pull up a little more.
Okay.
I'll grab that for you.
Okay. Thought maybe I'd ask for an air freshener then. Should I get an air freshener? So, you sell air fresheners?
Potpourri, lavender, jasmine, strawberry, and orange.
What do you think? How much are they? They are, I'll take a potpourri one. Sounds good?
Sounds good to me.
There we go. Blast it. Yeah. Air vent. There we go. See, they're so cool. Oh, I want to roll the window up, right? Put it in neutral. Yeah. I'm putting it in neutral. Yeah, he's not on. He doesn't want to be on. Putting it in neutral. This is real cool. What's this? The fresh blast. Vent. What is this goes in the... Where does this go? Oh, it sticks on your vent. Isn't this cool? It does smell good. It smells decent. These cars get so stuffy. This, and washes your dash. And I guess your window with that. Pretty cool, huh? Okay, this is, my son used to call this octopus, pentacles, he thought these were the octopus eyes, so, this is very cool, everything's soft brush, so this is a soft brush one. They put my mirrors in, that one, oop, they missed that one, but that's all right. It's partying. This is really cool. Because we've been so busy lately with everything going on, with the campaign and that, I don't have time to hand wash my car. I've got a sealant on this car. You've got to watch some of the places. This should be a pretty good one. This is a good quality place, and it's a nice town. And then the underbody blast. They're blasting my body. Here, my car. Here we go. What, is that the blast? Or? Looks like a little wax going on there, doesn't it? How about that? Maybe a little free wax there. Now here's a shot of air. There's the lions. Here, take a picture of them. Can you see them? have to, here, I'll put you out in the moonroof. Eric's gonna go out the top of the car. Sit down or the cops will catch you. We're very informal today. Marilyn Morgan again here in a different spot. We've just gone down the road. I've got my, we're gonna pull in the BP gas station here and I'm gonna wipe the car down because I didn't want to stand in front of their place just so people could get in and out because it's not one of those car washes where you do it yourself. Here we go. This is on Pontiac Trail, and so is the car wash. They're right near each other. And they sell a lot of good food here, a lot of good things. And we're gonna walk out. How's that? Yeah, it's air freshening. Well, they did a good job, yeah. Just a few spots, you know. My car was pretty dirty. Still work here, correct?
In the morning.
Yeah, she works in the morning. So if you came down here, you'd see her.
That's a post office in the building.
Yeah, that's right. You got a post office job in South Lyon?
New Hudson.
New Hudson, okay. New Hudson's real close to South Lyon. Because we're going down there.
4 miles.
Yeah, just 4 miles. These are your small towns.
What is that for?
Yeah, this is The Light. It's a cable show that we do, and it goes around Farmington, and then we bus it down to the rest of the different businesses.
All right, well, I really
want to know. So tell everybody your name.
Stacy.
This is Stacy.
Yeah.
Hi, Stacy.
There's Bill.
He's one of my favorite customers.
Yeah.
I don't get to see her very much anymore.
No. I'll see you later. Right. She's always busy. Did you buy it 2 years ago?
Almost 2 years ago.
So almost 2 years, so they fixed it up.
They fixed a lot of things.
Because this wasn't the same before, and there's quite a few things that you can get. They have chicken. You can actually get a meal when you come in this gas station. This is really good. It's a restaurant here. It's a regular restaurant, a carryout, but there's a place to sit outside. You could go sit in your car, but the food's really good. And that sort of thing. And all your pops, your juices. They've even got a Western Union in here. Talk about Malta. We're going up and down the chip aisle. For you cookie monsters, there's a, what are these little, I've never seen these little cheese bites in a cup. Nuts. Swing around here. Yeah, I can. I'm gonna go back around here. Oh, do we go down here? We wanna go down the other aisle. Back up, here, back up over here. Here we go. There's also a lot of car supplies, motor oil, anything that you need. And here's an air freshener, citrus. And you got everything that you need here. There's an ATM machine in here. A lot of gas stations are doing it. What would you call it, Eric? It's like a food shop, most places. So this definitely is a multi. Next door to this, they have another food place that they've got. They've got rock salt here, lots of different handheld ice cream, maps, papers. You got to read to know. And people trying to avoid the camera. They don't know what it's for. They might be something, the major TV. This is our science project. We're gonna go over and I'm gonna make the coffee and we're gonna get going on to the next stop.
Okay.
I'm having my usual, I put a lot of cream in this. The coffee is really good here. a lot of places it depends on the type of beans that they use. When it's a good quality bean, and the decaf tastes really good. That's what I have to drink now. Sometimes it's half and half. Up at the front, of course, they have your cigarettes and all different items. They've got batteries over there and film and all your candy and different, and of course, lottery tickets. You can't forget that. So this is, and they have the BP gas, so it's one of the places to go when you're in South Lyon. And trying to think if I forgot anything in here. Yeah, they we'll just be going outside in a minute, and we're going to drink our coffee and head on to the next place. See ya. What's that? More cream? More cream. More cream. That's what I keep putting it in there. I'm not on that much of a diet.
Hi. This time we're in front of Marketplace Pet Supplies store. And we're in South Lyon. We're in the strip mall down here on the corner of 9 Mile and Pontiac Trail. And this is a really nice sized store. We're gonna go in and talk to Dave, the owner, a bit. And then we're gonna meet, their cat's missing today. She's at the vet. They have a store cat. And they have a store, is it Bearded Dragon? It's cool, whatever it is. It's. We'll talk a little bit to, what is it?
Hank.
Oh, Hank, okay. So we'll go get introduced to everybody, and there's a young lady that works in there too. Come on in. Library Gecko, he donates the food for the library's geckos, so he's got thank you cards from them. It's real cool over there. So we're gonna walk over here. This is Dave. Dave, what is your last name?
Pasek.
Pasa?
Pasek.
Pasek?
Pasek, yeah.
Okay. And Dave, are you from South Lyon?
Yes.
Have you been here your whole life?
No.
Okay, where'd you come from?
From the Chicagoland area. I was transferred here a few years ago, with my job.
And what'd you do before this?
I was with Penske Logistics in the United Parcel Service.
See, that's different. So you started up this shop. I remember I met you down the other end of the mall.
Right, a year ago we started our store, a temporary location next to the dollar store.
Yeah, and then you got the chance to have a bigger store,
right,
which
well,
you needed.
We opened it temporarily while they were doing the renovation in this part of the facility.
Yeah, and this is really nice in here. We'll go over and show the folks your different things that you have.
Okay.
Okay.
Sure.
And now you own the store with your wife?
Yes, me and my wife are the sole owners of the store.
There you go. So this is a local business and a very nice shop. And as I was telling them, we're going to meet the female cat, not today, but we're going to go over and meet your, what is that, the Bearded Dragon,
oh,
Hank?
Hank, our Bearded Dragon, yes. He's kind of the store mascot. He's been here since June. And
he kind of.
Yeah, everybody that comes in the store always wants to see Hank.
So we'll go say hi to Hank. Thanks a lot, Dave. And
Alrighty.
We'll say goodbye to you before we leave. But
okay.
I know you've got plenty of customers and things
anything,
to do.
Just give me a holler while you're here. Be happy to help
okay.
you
Okay. Thanks.
Thank you.
Now, we're going to go over here and say hello to Hank.
Hi, guy. You got to bring, oh, look at him. For some reason, he favors this corner. Look. Hello. Hi. Hi, boy.
And I'm sure they can hear. Look at their little ear holes. It's all, they've got holes there. My son had a nose, but I don't know. Are these vegetarian? Here. I don't. Yeah, I see insects in there. I see some of his food. What is that in there? Is that a cricket or a bee? What does he eat? I don't know. I'll have to ask them exactly what they feed him. There's okay, and what is your name?
My name's Michelle Morgan. I work for Dave.
You got a cool last name. I'm Marilyn Morgan.
Yeah,
Michelle
I know
M.M.'s. Yeah, we had met before. Mm-hmm. Now, tell us a bit about what the Bearded Dragon eats, because I saw things in there, but I couldn't tell what I was seeing.
Hank eats a variety of vegetables and fruit, primarily lettuce, anything but iceberg, carrots.
Okay.
He likes raspberries and strawberries and things like that. And then he also gets crickets and mealworms.
I thought I saw something moving around in there. So he has, like us, a well-rounded diet, unless you're a vegetarian. And then so Hank's not going to eat some soy there. He likes a few little crickets.
Yeah, he likes his protein.
I saw something moving in the hole.
Yeah. He's a friendly little guy.
Yeah, he's really a cool character over there.
He sure is.
Then you'll get the little the female cat in here soon.
Yes.
She'll keep the mice away, and she'll play with Hank and keep him company.
And keep us company. She's a sweetie.
Yeah, because it's good to have pets around. I've got my cat at home, and I got to get some more.
That's
I got to get, because you usually need two. I say two of everything, right? Yeah,
that's
Dave's,
right.
Yeah, pears, you know.
That's right.
We're going to walk around the store. Come on with me. Eric's going to drag the camera. These are the different fish aquariums, okay? This is saltwater, all freshwater, guys. Ghost shrimp. Okay, sounds good, but I don't think you'd want to eat these guys. So all kinds of little fish. Are these salt? So all fresh, so that's good. So you don't have to have the temperature thing? Not as, down here, look at all these fish. All these guys, come on down here. Look at these beauties. And then he saw there's aquariums in here. So this is really cool. Lots of aquariums. I like these things, the borders. Come on down here. These are all the different food. We're just going to go by here real quick, but not too fast that you can't see what's going in here. There is so much variety of cat food, of dog food, and a good price. All your major traditional brands with some, I like to see the holistic brands that a lot of times you'll see in the different, health food stores and the different specialty stores. He has it all together, okay? So we're gonna go down here. Hairball control, there we go. For those hairy cats. They have every kind. I saw there was some sensitive stomach. There we go, light. There's my brand. If I was a cat, I'd be eating that all the time. Yeah, really, really good products. Come on down here. And then, of course, an assortment of, I love these, the scratchy places to climb. There we go. I can exercise my claws. And all the little, aren't these cool? They have a door on them. I've never seen them like that. I said there's an igloo one back there. Kind of eco cat litter, where it's good, the ecology, really good different brands there. It's really nice to see all that, where they recycle and the clays that they use. I won't read the brand, but it's safe for the earth. It's not strip mined, things like that where the clays are gotten naturally. You know, Maryland, I see that. As well as the all the different other ones. All kinds of kitty litter. This is kitty litter here. Excuse me, how are you doing, sir? This is just cable TV.
Oh.
Do you live in South Lyon?
Yeah.
How long have you been shopping here?
I don't know, a few months.
Yeah, they've been open the year, and there's a lot here. I was just looking around at all the different brands, the different things.
Yeah.
What to get the pets for Christmas, you know?
That's always a good question.
Exactly, yeah. So they have all kinds of toys and things. Yeah, here's the, good talking to you, sir.
All right, thank you.
Here's a, look at this. That's cool. It looks like a little igloo. You go up inside designer kitty litter boxes. What is it? This has got, oh, a dog litter pan? I didn't know they existed. Okay. I learned something new. Oh, the doggy and kitty doors. Look at this bone. That wouldn't be for a chihuahua. Okay. Just comb through here. So you can see there's a lot going on. And for more of a small town store, there's a lot of stuff here. Trophy rock, big game. Oh, they even have deer corn and stuff like that. Smoked bovine meaty hocks. Mmm, those look good. We're starting to get hungry. Even that starts to sound good, Eric. Let's see, all the different shampoos and different things like that. Come on down here. Then, of course, since it's a pet shop, there's all kinds of things for birdies. And, and of course you can't forget the hamsters and the rabbits and different things like that. Tons of feed. They have the different containers for feed that you can buy. Coming down here, I like this part. I was looking at the little the doggy beds that they had. This is a protector. It can be a protector or an outdoor pet bed. I thought that caught my eye. I like those kind of things. And all the different types of beds they got. I love this. It's fitting. Come on down here. I'm pulling it from the camera. Pulled the different things, the filters for the aquarium. So this is the pet shop, okay? We're going to say goodbye to these folks and go on to our next stop. We're going to head on down to Midtown. We'll introduce you to some cool people who do a very nice thing for a worthy cause. And thank you, Dave. It was a pleasure checking your store out and showing everybody what you have down here.
Well, thank you very much for stopping in. I appreciate it. Like I said, we've only been in town for about a year now, and seems like we're kind of filling a little niche that the community has had a need for, and we're glad to be here. We really appreciate all the customers that we have and the involvement.
That way we don't have to drive all over town, way across town to, about 20 minutes away from here to get our products. You're right around the corner from my house. So thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Take
thanks
care.
For stopping in.
Happy
Bye-bye.
Holidays.
Yes, you too.
Yeah, thanks. Hi. We're down here. I have the pleasure of introducing you to a couple of people that do some good community work for a very good cause, and they're going to explain this in brief. I've got the flyer here, South Lyon Community Support Team, and here are two of its members. Ladies first, and I met Cindy. And she also does other things. She's a clown. Well, a professional clown. And what is your last name?
Jackson.
Okay. Tell me first how you got involved with this project.
It was 7-8 years ago. There was a child that was sick in the community, was diagnosed with cancer, and several people in the community knew this family. So we were wanting to help this family as they were in, financial straits with the child, so when their child was sick. So Tony Sparks from the Kiwanis actually got us together originally, and he said we should organize a support team that will help ill children, and that's what we did with from this one family we helped. Then we got organized and
In group.
How long ago was that?
That was, I think, 8 years ago. 8 years
and
ago.
It's grown since.
And so what we do is we help ill children. We help children with devastating illness. And it doesn't necessarily have to be just cancer, but any child who's very sick and has a devastating illness, we help.
And you do this in the community area, the children around in the Metro Detroit area?
We cover about a 25-mile circular radius from South Lyon,
okay.
And we help all families. We pretty much raise money and help with monetary issues for the family, whether it's paying rent, mortgages, utilities, things like that.
Because it's hard when children, I'll ask that story you told me, but I'm going to introduce your name, sir?
Kenny Walkup.
And Kenny is specialty medicine downtown here next to the pharmacy. What is this area you work in? What do you do?
I own a compounding pharmacy.
And what is that different with the other?
All the medications we dispense, we make from scratch.
That's very good, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So you know where to get our, go to get well.
Mm-hmm.
So this is a connection, too, because you find out about these children.
We've gotten a few people that have come to us, through my business, that have come to the support team that we've been able to, to help financially. Yeah.
Okay. So, how did you first get started? What were you doing?
About 4 years ago, I owned the pharmacy next door, and the support team approached me about doing deliveries for senior citizens. So we started out making the deliveries for the senior citizens in town, and the support team covered the cost of all that. And then I just started going to meetings and becoming more and more involved. And
right. And, you
start and now he's president. He's president of the group.
Of the South Lyon Community Support Team. So this is a very worthy cause to be noted for, and they'd like more people to understand about this. Now, you told me a lovely story about a little girl that touched me.
Yeah, I was telling her about the story about the little girl who did the artwork, and we auctioned off the picture at our annual golf outing. Our golf outing is held in July every year, usually at the links in Novi, and I think this will be our last year there, but for any golfers who are interested. But that's how we get our majority of our money to help these families, is through the golf outing. And one of our auction items this year, or 2 years ago it was a painting, a crayon drawing actually by this little girl who was a patient at U of M Mats. And she drew this picture of dolphins, I believe, and even wrote a little paragraph, a story about her feelings about it. And she, we used that as an auction item. And the little girl, was she able to come to the outing?
She came to the outing and she held it up and told a story about her picture. And one of the gentlemen at the outing bought it from her.
Yes, But it, you know, I can I say how much it went for?
That was exciting.
That was exciting. It actually went for $500, and that was used to help. You know, that little girl helped other children by doing that picture, and it was just so touching. The man who bought it had tears down his face and said it reminded him of another child he knew that was sick, and it just touched us all. And even the children come to the golf outing if they're well enough and they're out of clinic that day, and they can come, and they think it's a party, and it is a party, and it is a party for them, and we give them gifts too that day. And the children come, and it's just a wonderful atmosphere to see all the people in the community and the golfers who stay and give so much.
In addition to just helping the families with monetary issues, we also help send every child from Mats that wants to go to a place called Camp Make a Dream, which is a camp for terminally ill children that's out in Montana.
Okay.
And any child that wants to go, we pay their airfare to fly them out. And once they get there, it's free. And it's a place where kids can just be a normal kid for a week, no matter how sick they are. And all their care is taken care of for them once they arrive there.
Really? A lot of the staff is nurses and doctors, a lot of the staff at the camp, so they're well cared for. And
Camp Make a Dream was founded by a local couple that bought a big, huge piece of property in Montana and founded this organization.
Yeah. Isn't that wonderful?
They have a beautiful pool, they have facilities for the children to go horseback riding, and just to have one normal week in their life and in the summer. And so any child that's ill can make arrangements to go there.
Now, and you were saying that they do have an application that they have to go through?
Yes,
There's an application process. Anybody that needs an application can go to our website, which is www.slcst.org.
Okay.
And numbers are on there to contact us, whether it's myself or the head of our interviews or George and Cindy. And we'll send them out the application. There's an application to fill out and an interview process. We go to their home and interview the family. And then we determine if, what level of need they need and where we can assist and help them out.
So there, if there's anybody that you know of that needs help like this, let them know. If you'd like to donate, certainly do that. And they have a lovely golf outing. And anything you can do to help this group or become a part of it, let them know, and they'll be glad to help you. Yeah. Thank you very much.
Thanks.
Been wonderful talking
Thank
with you.
You.
Thank
Marilyn.
You.
Yes.
With Deborah. What is your last name, Deborah?
Kiefer.
And we had talked earlier with the ladies that worked here and gone around the store and drank coffee and talked with some customers, and that was fun. So now we're going to talk a little bit with Deborah to see what's on her mind, her thoughts about her shop here. And I understand that you own this solely. This is just your shop?
That's correct. Yes.
I like to see more women in business. This doesn't happen very often. It's not the easiest thing. Not that we aren't capable, but to be able to have the means or the mind or the time away from children and doing different things and different our other jobs or where we can get to a position in life,
that came your
safe. We have a lot of experience of pulling a lot of different elements together, and that's what you need to be able to do when you're pulling together the construction aspect and the financial aspect, the product aspect, and then just finally getting to the place where you can open.
And you opened, a year ago?
A year ago, last month.
Okay.
So we made it through the first year. Hooray.
Yeah, and that's an accomplishment. It's going strong. Your decor is really pretty. I talked to you before
about that. Who did you get someone to design this for you?
No, I did all the design work and actually did a lot of the actual physical work.
Whoa.
Putting this together too. Customers, we've succeeded in that.
Oh,
so.
Yeah, because the decaf is great, and a lot of times if it isn't a good bean, that's a hard one to duplicate because process.
We use Swiss water process decaffeination, so there's no chemicals used in the decaffeination of the coffees. So.
And that's a big difference. That makes good for the flavor.
Yeah, and we carry fair trade coffees too, which are important. Those fair trade coffees are where the growers and the pickers of those coffee receive fair price for their coffee and living wage for their coffee. So that's
good.
Important.
That is important.
As far as the world economy goes.
Maryland calls it good karma. Good for your business. I do bewitch lots of success. I do wish you great success in the future with your business. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, Marilyn.
Take care. I'll see you later. You know that. You do. Thanks a lot, folks. This wraps up this edition of Walking Downtown South Lyon. And this will air out soon. Happy holidays to everybody. And by the time you get there, it's probably Happy New Year by the time this shows. Thank you very much. Bye-bye.